Dear chess friends, this is Jiří Dufek on Royal Chess Channel, and today I'll show you game Bulochkin-Haba, which was played a few weeks ago, and in this game was played very interesting system against London system, and I'm sure you do this interesting idea. Let's start. Game started. d4, d5, bishop f4, which is accelerated London system. White wants to postpone the development of knight g1 because he thinks that this move can be played any time later, and he wants to slightly limit black choice for our next few moves. Then black played c5, e3, knight c6, start normal development, c3, queen b6, and queen b3, which is more or less my line in this sideline. And now, if black will play knight f6, for example, then after knight e2, c4, queen c2, white is prepared to play e4 or b3 very quickly. And this is why knight f6 is probably not the best move. And black in this position is more or less forced to play c4. And after c4, queen c2 is a logical move. And now the mostly played move, bishop f5, is a mistake, because this move is played with idea that white cannot take on f5 because b2 pawn hanging, but in fact this is small trap for because white is ready to sacrifice rook on a1, and he thinks that the queen on a1 will be trapped, and he's probably right. For example, after queen takes d5, queen takes a1, queen b5, attack on b7 pawn, a6, queen takes b7, double attack on c6 and a8, knight d8, queen e4, queen b2, bishop take c4, and in correspondence game Nevruger-Baraniuk, white has two pawns for exchange and very good development, strong initiative, and he's probably even winning in this position. Other try is after queen d5, but can try knight f6, which was played by Fominich. And after queen takes c4, queen c1 check, king e2, queen b2 check. Of course, after king e1, queen c1 check is repetition, then king f3 is only move. And now black is forced to take a rook on a1. After queen b3, black queen is locked on a1. And now simple plan to bishop d3, knight f3, knight e2, and then knight b1 to somewhere, probably to d2, and then black will lose a queen. The game continued. Long castle, g3, e6, king g2, defend rook on h1, knight e4, knight f3. And now white played inaccurately bishop d3. And even after that, white position was preferable, but clearly better move was knight f3 now. Because after bishop d6, bishop d3, knight a5, queen c2, black will lose his queen in a very next move. This is why after queen c2, bishop f5 doesn't have any sense. And Peter Haba played much more interesting move, which is e5. It is in Albin style. And black is ready to sacrifice one or two pawns to get pieces out and get a strong initiative. Now, in the game was played d takes e5. Probably not so bad is even bishop takes e5. Knight takes d e5. Bishop f5. Now the now queen takes f5 doesn't work. Then it means queen c1 only move. F6, knight f3, fe, knight takes e5, bishop c5. And black pieces are very quickly on the right squares. And after bishop e2, knight f6, knight d2, short castle, knight e f3, rook a8, black has a very nice compensation for a pawn. But in the game, white played d takes e5. Now bishop f5 is sensible move. Oh. And after queen c1, we have a first critical position for black, because in this position, yes, as minimum three very sensible moves. First move is knight g e7 with idea knight g6 and taking the e5 pawn back. Probably the sensible continuation of the game would be knight f3, knight g6, bishop g3, and now maybe even h5, h4, bishop c5, bishop e2, both short castle, bishop g4, knight bd2, rook f8, and I think black is very solid. Probably he will regain e5 pawn very soon, and then maybe knight d3 will be option in a future. Second very interesting move, which wasn't played, is gambit style move f6, which I like very well. I think that it may be even better than move which was played in a game. After knight f3, g5, bishop g3, h5, black has very strong initiative on the king side. It's questionable where white king will be hidden, because on the king side there is a pawn attack, and on queen side it will take a lot of time, and I don't see a simple way how to do it. If we will continue in this line, h3, long castle, bishop e2, f takes e5, knight takes e5, bishop d6, knight takes e6, queen takes e6, bishop d6, queen takes, b3, knight e7. White is probably okay, but in a practical game it's not so easy to solve all problems with white king. Second option after f6 is maybe principal taking on f6 and ask to black if he has enough compensation for a pawn. After knight f6, knight f3, knight e4, knight bd2, knight c5, looking for the d3 square, which is very weak. Now white is probably forced to play knight d4, and after knight takes d4, ed, queen e6, bishop e5, bishop e6, black will regain pawn back and he will has a very nice position. Knight f3, short castle, dc, bishop e5, queen e3, bishop f6, queen e6, bishop e6, and white will take on c5 sooner or later, and his position is very good. Yes, two bishops, open files, and very good position. In a position, Peter Hammer played very interesting move too, and it is g5. Now, maybe very good tries to take the pawn on g5 and ask black if he has enough compensation after knight e5, knight d2, f6, bishop f4, knight e7, and now it's probably white is forced to take on e5, and after bishop takes e5, fe, knight gf3, bishop g7, black position looks very good to me, because two bishops, well, big pawn center, d3 square is very weak, good development, short castle, open f line, and so on. I think black is in a good shape. For example, bishop e2, knight g6, b3, cb, ab, rook c8. And now it's questionable what will white play in next few moves. But after g5, Bulochkin played bishop g3, which looks quite logical. And after h5, it's basic question, h3 or h4. In a game, Bulochkin played h4, and I think probably this is even losing mistake. Slightly better looks h3. And after knight h6, knight f3, bishop g7, knight bd2, and now it's probably time to play h4, bishop h2, g4, knight takes h5, b4, bishop e6, queen c2, bishop takes e5, a pawn castle, and black has very nice composition for a pawn. In reality, probably he's not better, but he will probably regain pawn back on the king side, because open files and two bishops are so strong that I think that white will look for some exchanges, and probably he will sacrifice pawn back. But after h4, g takes h4, rook takes h4, and knight g7. Now it's very hard to find a sensible move for white, because knight g6 and knight takes e5 is a simple threat, but a very big one. And there is no way how to play against it. In this position, I think computers suggest something like knight d2 and sacrifice exchange after knight g6. Knight gf3, knight takes h4, bishop takes h4, and queen c7. But it's clear that in this position, compensation for exchange is not enough. At the time, there is pawn for exchange, but pawn on e5 is very weak, and there is no clear what should be played with white pieces. It means this is why white tried to something else. He played e4, and he tried to exchange e3 pawn for d5 and c4 pawn. After bishop takes e4, now he sacrificed exchange, and he took on c4 with bishop. Bishop takes c4. He got for a while some activity, but in fact it's not enough, because after simple bishop h6, queen c2, and long castle, it's clear that the black is clearly winning. He developed all pieces. Yes, strong initiative. B2, g2 pawns are very weak. White king is in the center. He will be targeted in a few moves, and white has nearly all pieces on a basic on started square. Game continued, knight e2, h4, bishop h2, and after rook hg8, g2 pawn is hanging. And there is no way how to defend it, because after a move which was played in a game, in f1, black found very nice and simple tactics with the move, queen takes b2. Because queen on c2 is overloaded, and it cannot defend b2 pawn and d1 at one moment. And this is why this move is winning. Why try to play bishop b3? But it, of course, doesn't defend rook on a1, queen takes a1, and after e6, with some idea, f takes e6, bishop takes e6, check. But black finished a game with a simple move, rook d2. And it's time to resign. And this is what white did, and to resign it in this position. So, if we will make some conclusion in this line, I think that after queen b3 c4, Queen c2 e5. This is very interesting line, and it's questionable if white shouldn't look for another move order, because this is a very concrete line, and white need to find a solution for this gambit line. Thank you for watching, and see you next time.